Good evening and welcome to I'm Chris Parnell.
Reporting from Moscow.
Tbilisi.
Times Square.
May your dreams be your only boundaries in life.
Germantown High School's award-winning TV studio, GHS-TV, it's time for Wake Up Germantown.
Wake Up Germantown, it's 39 degrees on this Friday, January 29th. I'm Jasmine Saulsberry. Joining me are school news anchor Raneem Imam and sports anchor Bryan Scott. But before we get to them, let's take a look at our today's top stories. Michigan State Senate has approved $28 million to help the city of Flint recover from its toxic water crisis. The crisis started in 2014 when the city of Flint switched to the Flint River to save money for its drinking water. However, the river contained corrosive chlorine, which ate away at the lead piping that the water flowed through, making the water toxic. Donations are pouring in. This week, the city of Memphis, FedEx, and MLGW sent 12,000 bottles of clean water to Flint. The Zika virus that has been sweeping through the Americas has reached the South. The Arkansas Department of Health confirmed a resident tested positive for the virus this week. According to the Associated Press, another case was confirmed in Virginia. Experts say others are not at risk due to the lack of mosquitoes in the winter months. Monday, the World Health Organization will hold an emergency meeting to address the concerns over the Zika virus. U.S. leaders say clinical trials on a vaccine could begin this year. Taking a look at news a little closer to home, many Tennessee college freshmen are not ready for college. That's according to a new study. 28% of freshmen at the three UT campuses and 45% of U of M freshmen did not meet their school's criteria for college readiness in math, reading, or writing. Tennessee has several initiatives underway in kindergarten through 12th grade focused on addressing student academic weakness earlier to eliminate the need for later remediation. 2 weeks ago, Germantown High School's very own thespian troupe 912 took a trip to Middle Tennessee State University to participate in the 2016 Tennessee State Thespian Conference. More than 800 students from 37 Tennessee schools participated in a variety of workshops hosted by industry professionals. In addition, some of our juniors and seniors had the chance to audition for college theater programs and scholarships. This was a great experience for students wanting to pursue a theater career after high school. More than 160,000 teens skip school every day. The reason? Bullying. Whether it's physical, verbal, or cyber, bullying is having an effect on students. Reporter Ryan Coleman and videographer Connor Sackett try to get a better understanding on how to prevent bullying in this Wake Up Germantown report.
Get some friends, loser.
He would call me names and push me and punch me and kick me and all that.
The numbers are alarming. According to the National Bullying Prevention Center, one in four high school students report being bullied every year. And these students are at increased risk for poor school adjustment, sleep deprivation, anxiety, and depression.
I was very sensitive and very, very easily hurt and stuff, so when he would call me names, it would just shatter my confidence.
For some, learning self-defense is their way of taking back control. Here in Memphis, Scorpion Martial Arts strives to teach teens safe ways to fight back without actually fighting.
We do a series of basic concepts, which helps build the child's confidence.
But there are other ways to combat bullying. Peer-to-peer mediation programs and intervention counselors sit down with students and their bullies to get down to the underlying problem.
Some students are bullies because they either have problems at home or they are angry at other people's successes.
Experts say the best way to stop bullying is to speak up.
What I would recommend that child to do is to tell someone. Tell that adult, tell that teacher, tell your parents.
We do not let one bullying situation go untouched. Our faculty is up. They know exactly what they need to do. But as a staff, Germantown High School counseling staff, every one of us can handle and address bullying.
And if you see someone being bullied, speak up for them. Not saying anything could make it worse. Reporting for WMC Action News 5.
Bro, you all right, man?
I'm Ryan Coleman, News 101.
For more information on ways to stop or prevent bullying, visit stopbullying.gov.
Scarlett Simpson here with today's 24 frame trivia question. Earlier this month, Star Wars The Force Awakens surpassed Avatar as the highest domestic grossing film of all time. In the original Star Wars trilogy, who does the Millennium Falcon belong to? Was it A, Obi-Wan Kenobi, B, Darth Vader, or C, Han Solo? Think you know? We'll reveal the answer right after Tech Talk.
Over half a dozen games are set for release in 2016, and the most anticipated one is Street Fighter V. The fifth game in the series comes out next month. With a new graphic design and an innovative adaptable battle mechanics, the maker Capcom has created a platform that is simple for both beginners and veteran players. In Uncharted 4, Nathan Drake is in search of a historical pirate treasure after years of being a meek hunter. However, Drake faces multiple challenges as he sacrifices and tests his mental and physical limits against one of his greatest adventures yet. Uncharted 4 releases February 4th, but pre-order is still available. Cobalt, Firewatch, Battleborn, and No Man's Sky are also some of the highly anticipated games coming out this year. I'm AJ Kokoff, signing off from another edition of Tech Talk.
I'm Vontrell Thomas with a look at the hottest songs in America, according to Billboard's Hot 100. With her top five debut, Alyssa Cara is here to stay. 21 Pilots aren't stressed out. Their single is sitting at number 4. Adele says hello to the number 3 spot, dropping one spot this week. Justin Bieber is king of the charts, taking the number 1 and 2 positions. His latest single, Love Yourself, dethroned Adele for the number 2 spot. And coming in at number 1 for the third straight week is his mega hit, Sorry. That's all from Top 5. I'm Vontrell Thomas.
Just a moment ago, we asked you, in the classic Star Wars trilogy, who does the Millennium Falcon belong to? The answer, C, Han Solo. That's it for 24 Frame Trivia. I'm Scarlett Simpson.
Now let's find out what Germantown High School students and teachers need to know. Raneem Imam brings us today's school news.
Here are today's GHS announcements. Do you have questions about AP or honors classes? Wondering what leadership programs are offered in the summer? Or are you looking for scholarship information? Then log on to the GHS Counselors website at ghscounselors.weebly.com. It's got all the information you need and much more. Attention NHS members, there will be a regular meeting this afternoon at 2:25 in the library. Model UN members, a reminder that the White Station Conference is today, after school. Anyone interested in playing tennis should see Coach Taylor in room A217 for forms and recommendation letters. If you do not complete the necessary paperwork, you cannot try out. The Little Mermaid is getting ready to swim onto the Poplar Pike Playhouse stage. Tickets are already on sale for the highly anticipated regional premiere. Students, you can get tickets for just $10 if you come on the designated student nights on February 26th and 27th. Stop by the box office in C Building to reserve your seats or log on to ppp.org to buy them online. The show runs February 25th through March 12th. And finally, today's lunch will include fish tacos, vegetarian nachos, entree salad, fresh fruit, chilled fruit cup, and milk. That's all the school news for today. Back to you, Jasmine.
Thanks, Renee. Now let's get an update on the world of sports, both here in Germantown and beyond. Bryan Scott has today's sports report. Bryan Scott joins us now. Bryan, you're trying something new this week with your sports report.
That's right, Jasmine. We're calling it the 2-Minute Drill. We get you caught up with the latest and greatest in the world of sports in 120 seconds or less. We start this morning with the Grizzlies. Last night, the boys in blue battled against the Bucks in what turned out to be a very heated matchup. Some great ball movement by the Grizz early in the second ended up in a sensational slam for Jeff Green. The Bucks came right back down the floor with some fast break offense of their own, with an alley-oop from Chris Middleton to Michael Carter-Williams. But the Grizz proved just to be too much, with the grindfather himself even pitching in on the action with a baseline drive and jam. Jeff Green had 21 points and 5 boards off the bench, and Gasol added 15 and 8 to put the Memphis Grizzlies over the Milwaukee Bucks, 103-83. Now, how could we cover sports without talking about the game on everybody's minds? Super Bowl 50 is next weekend, and Panther and Bronco fans all across the nation will be tuning in. But how did they get there? The Broncos took down reigning Super Bowl champs, the Patriots, in Denver last Sunday, 20-18. And Carolina booked their ticket to the Super Bowl the day before, beating Arizona 49-15. Make sure to tune in Sunday, February the 7th. Start time is 5 p.m. on CBS. My prediction? Broncos take the upset in what many think is Manning's last rodeo. I'm taking the Broncos 24-21 in overtime. And finally, I've got to give some love to our Red Devils varsity basketball team. With some really big wins and only one loss this late into the season, they're looking to finish their season out strong with some wins against some tough opponents. The Red Devils did just that and more this past Tuesday against Kirby. DB Cinco led the team with 22 points. And Lucky Cheatham added 12 points of his own to help Germantown take down Kirby. Final score, 64-44. Next stop on the road to state, Germantown will take on Southwind tonight in what looks like will be one of the biggest games of the season. Make sure to pick up your tickets before they sell out. How far will Germantown make it into the playoffs? Who do you have winning the Super Bowl? Send us a tweet at GHS-TV Sports with your answers. As always, go Red Devils! Jasmine, back to you.
Bryan, I'm a Steelers fan through and through, but I'll be rooting on the Panthers next week.
You know, the Panthers are looking for their first championship, so it should be a great game.
Thanks, Bryan. If you have a GHS story you think our reporters should cover, let us know. Leave us a comment on our GHS-TV Facebook page or drop a note in the announcements box in C Office. Make sure you include your name and the phone number or email address. Finally, taking a look at this weekend's weather, Saturday will be sunny with a high of 65 degrees and a low of 55 degrees. Sunday, expect cloudy skies and a high of 65 degrees and a low of 48 degrees. That's all the news from around the world and here at home. From all of us here at GHS-TV, have a great day.
For those who wish to participate, please stand and join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In accordance with state law, Germantown High School will now observe a moment of silence. Thank you, and have a great day.